Hey, what's going on, guys? This is Gaming Fiends. This video is going to be how to defeat Kargath Bladefist and the mechanics of this fight. You see me doing it on normal, but this is also helpful if you're doing it in LFR or normal. But if you're doing it in mythic or heroic or something like that, chances are you'll probably have other stuff that I don't mention in this video. But this is just the basic mechanics and what you need to know before fighting this boss on normal or LFR difficulty. So, as you see him doing now, he's picking me up and impaling me. He does that to whoever has aggro with him, and it applies a stack of impale. And it also makes you take more damage from impale. So, once you get one tank gets one or two stacks of that, the other tank is going to want to taunt off. Kargath will also focus a DPS and chase after them, like you just saw happen. You'll have to pull him into the flame pillar, and it will stun him for a short period of time. So if he starts focusing you and chasing after you, similar to that dinosaur boss in Siege of Orgrimmar, just simply kite him through one of the flame pillars that are active. It's those skulls that are spewing fire. Okay, here he's impaling me again. So at this point, the other tank is going to want to taunt off of me once he's done impaling me. Okay, now what you see here is Chain Hurl. He's going to pick up five of the closest players and throw them into the stance. So there's going to be a designated group before the fight starts of five people. If you're in that group, you're going to want to stand as close to him as you can when he uses Chain Hurl, and he's going to throw you into the stance. And if you're a tank, you're just going to drop all these adds in the stance and just DPS, fight him, healer, heal. It's going to be three DPS, one tank, and one healer that go up into the stance. If you're not in the designated group to go in the stance, when he uses Chain Hurl, make sure you're far away from him because you don't want to be picked up, because he picks up the five closest players. Alright, so you just fight up here if you're in the stands until you get thrown back down. And he'll usually use Chain Hurl about twice in the fight. In this encounter, he only used it twice, and there's only two groups of people that had to go into the stands. And whichever tank has more stacks, so if you're the tank that has more stacks of Impale debuff, then you're going to want to go up into the stands, and the other tank is going to fight Kargath down in the arena while the other tank is up in the stands. The traps on the ground are for tigers. There's tigers in those traps, and if you stand on there and they fall in and collapse, then you'll fall into the tiger pit and you'll die. So make sure you don't stand there. You see those green spots on the ground. You also want to stay out of that. Another thing that I probably should have mentioned a while ago was that you want to lust at the very start of this fight. So, you know, time warp, bloodlust, whatever, at the very start of the fight. And that's pretty much the basic of this fight. A quick recap, if Kargath targets you and starts chasing after you, run him through those flame pillars. If you're tanking, make sure to taunt off the other tank when he has one or two stacks of the Impale debuff. Don't stand over the tiger traps, and make sure that you're not standing too close to Kargath when he does his Chain Hurl if you're not in the designated group. If you are in the designated group, stand as close to Kargath as possible so that he will throw you into the stands, and the five closest players will go into the stands and fight until it's time to go back down. If you are tanking in that group of five, as soon as you get back down, you're going to want to re-taunt Kargath. By the time you're out of the stands, your Impale debuff should have expired, and you want to taunt Kargath as soon as you get back down. So that's basically it, guys. The next video I'm going to make is for the Butcher, which is the next boss. I might get to Brackenspore and Tectus as well, but this is the first boss for Highmaul, and I hope this was helpful to you. Good luck, and I hope you guys can do this encounter with as few wipes as possible. Thanks for watching.